Okay, this is pre-algebra for part two. Now, if you notice, if you're thinking, wait a minute, Mrs. Turner, that problem that you just did I didn't get the same answer. If you wrote what was in the book, I did not on the board. So that might be a little bit of a problem. Let's look at a couple more problems though. All right, let's look at what we have here on the board. Let's start with, I don't know where it is on your book, but let's do this on the board. If a smart person would write these down as you're going along, because they'll be helpful to you later. Positive 6 times a positive 3. Both of these numbers are positive, so my answer is positive 18. Negative 6 times negative 3. They're both negative, so my answer is positive 18. Okay? Negative 6 and positive 3. The answer is negative 18. Why? Because my signs are different. Okay? Here I have a positive 6 and times a negative 3. So my answer is negative 18. All right, let's look over here. We're going to add some positive and negative numbers. You can see that I'm adding all of these, and everything has a parenthesis around it. That's to put the sign with that number, and then we're adding everything. So we're going to say negative 6 plus negative 2, negative 8. Negative 8 plus a negative 5 is a negative 13. Negative 13 plus a negative 4 is a negative 17. Negative 17 plus a positive 3. Negative 14 plus a positive 3. Negative 17 plus a positive 3 is going to be a negative 14. Look at this next one. Negative 7 plus positive 3 is negative 4. Negative 4 plus a negative 31 gives us a negative 35. Negative 35 plus a positive 3. Negative 35 and positive 3 gives us a negative 32. When you do the multiplication of scientific notation, you have 7 times 10 to the 14th power times 1 times 10 to the negative 12. What are we going to do? We're going to say, let's take the first numbers and multiply them. So 7 times 1 is 7. Keep your times 10 and say 10 to the 14th plus, or multiplying it, which really means we're just going to add our exponents. So we have 14 and a negative 12. So what do we have? We have a negative 2. So the answer is 7 times 10 to the negative second power. Let's look at one more problem together, and that is this orders of operation, okay? Let's look at this orders of operation. It says 2 to the 4th power plus the square root of 25 plus 2 to the 2 squared parentheses 3 squared minus 2 to the 3rd power parentheses 2 squared plus 1 minus 1, and then our bracket. Now, that being said, what's the first thing you're going to do? You're going to do your powers and your exponents, okay? So 2 to the 4th power, what is that? Well, 2 times 2 is 4, 4 times 2 is 8, 8 times 2 is 16, that's to the 4th power. That's 16. Plus the square root of 25 is 5, put a bracket. Now we have 2 squared. 2 squared means 2 times 2, so that is 4, parentheses, because remember, all we're doing is getting rid of all those exponents and powers and roots and things like that. We're not combining anything yet, okay? So we have 3 squared, which means 3 times 3 is 9, minus 2 to the 3rd. That means 3 times, so 2 times 2 is 4, times 2 is 8, okay? Put our parentheses. Now we have 2 squared. 2 times 2 is 4. Plus 1, minus 1, and then our bracket. Now what do we do? Now we do the parentheses, okay? So we're not going to do anything to the numbers outside. Put our bracket. 4, I can't do anything with it because it's not inside my innermost parentheses. My innermost parentheses say 9 minus 8 is 1. Then we have 4 plus 1 is 5, minus 1, and then our bracket. Now we stay inside our inclusion symbols. In this case, they're brackets. So we're going to say 16 plus 5, and we're going to put a bracket. Now, here I have to stop and think. I have 4 times 1 times 5 minus 1 all inside my bracket. What do I do first? You multiply and divide left to right, then you add and subtract. So 4 times 1 is 4. 4 times 5 is 20. 20 minus 1 is 19. Okay? So remember, you're going to do everything inside those brackets first. Now I have a 16. Now I have 5 times 19. Okay, so 5 times 9 is 45. 5 times 1 is 5 plus the 4 gives us a 9. So we have 16 plus 95. All we're going to do is add. 6 and 5 is 11. 1 plus 9 plus the 1 I carry gives me 11. So my final answer is 111. Today we just did a lot of review, making sure that you are ready. I'm finding that on your test, it's not that you're not understanding the concepts. I'm finding like when you're doing this, you're making silly mistakes. Like some of you would have gotten to the bottom of this and you would have added this wrong. Be very careful. Make sure you're checking your test. Make sure you're doing your very, very, very best, okay? Because there is no go back and get extra credit or part credit. You take a test and it comes in, and that is the grade that you have. All right, go ahead and do your homework before you do your quiz. I hope you took good notes on this today, because you'll see why when you do your homework. Have a good day, guys.